Welcome back, guys. Today I have a tech video for you. It is related to a car project, but this is going to be applicable for anything you need an accelerometer for. I selected Adafruit's MMA8451 accelerometer sensor. It uses I2C and it has a sampling rate of 800 hertz. This is just to help you get this set up for yourself. Adafruit's example codes have a lot of fluff in them that you don't really need, so I'm going to show you what the bare minimum is to get started with this sensor. This took me about 5 minutes to get going. I just plugged it into the M0 data logger from Adafruit as well, and it worked right out of the box, no problem. So the first thing you're going to need to do is install any boards that you're going to use. I'm assuming you know how to do that. If not, there's a lot of videos out there. Also on Adafruit's website, if you're using one of their boards, they always have a good tutorial about how to get those installed. The next thing you need to do is install the sensor. So the sensor is the Adafruit underscore MMA8451. That's the library name. It'll also install a few dependencies, and then you'll be ready to go. So you want to include these libraries right here. And then initialize the MMA sensor object, and that'll look like this. Points, lim, and ran are just a few variables I added to basically manage how much it runs. That way we only get one run, we can set the number of data points we want, and we're good to go. Pretty standard stuff, serial begin, serial print line. This is initializing the sensor. And then it lets you know, hey, found it, we're good to go. So this is the first configuration line. So the sensor can go from, it can use the limits of plus or minus 2 Gs, 4 Gs, or 8 Gs. You typically want to use the lowest limit that you need. That way you can get more resolution in the range that you're operating in. So if I'm trying to evaluate my suspension and I set it at 4 Gs, and I only notice, you know, values between like 1.5 and negative 1.5 Gs, I'm gonna reduce it to a 2G limit, so that way I can get more resolution in that range. Obviously, if you have it set to 4 Gs or 2 Gs and you see values clipping, that means just like it's maxed out for a few data points and then it comes back down, you're gonna wanna increase the range. That way you can capture those data points that went outside of the range that you have it set to. So we're just gonna start out with 2 Gs right here. This just prints a line, says, hey, this is the range. But we're going to get out of, I'll leave it in, whatever. So this is our loop. We just check, hey, if ran false, keep going. So if it's already run, it'll just stop and be like, all right, we're good. MMA.read. That reads the registers from the sensor. T equals millis. If you want to use the difference between each data point in time, or the time difference between each data point, you would put millis minus T here, but we're not going to do that because we want to be able to plot. So we're just going to comment that out, free up a few clock cycles here. So we're going to print, so it's easy to open as a CSV. So we're gonna serial.print MMA.z. That is the raw value. I recommend if you wanna record as quickly as possible, only record raw values, and that will keep the bottleneck from being your microcontroller. Since we can convert to Gs if we want afterwards. So MMA.z, that's the raw value from the sensor, print comma, and then print millis. That's gonna give us the timestamp that we need to plot the data. This is left over from a different program when I was writing to an SD card. If you're interested in that, leave a comment. I'll show you how to do it. And then points plus plus just adds one integer to the variable points. So it can say, hey, once we reach the limit, 5,000 data points for this one, go ahead and stop. I'm going to say serial print done, ran equals true. That way it won't loop through again. So let's go ahead and load that. I'm gonna shake it around. Okay, let's try that again. Woo, and there we go. Okay, so what I'm going to do is record this to an SD card with a text file, and then show you what the output would look like. Okay, so here we can see the output from the sensor. So column A is just the raw value. B is the value converted from the raw value to G's, and that's going to be whatever this raw value is. You're going to divide that by the 2 to the 14th power, since it's a 14-bit processor or a 14-bit sensor. And then you're going to divide the 16,000, which is 2 to the 14th, by 2, because you're measuring from negative to positive. So it's 2 G's on either side. Divide that by 2, and then that should give you the value in G's. And so you can plot just the raw values here, or if you plot the value of G's, you can see that here. If you're just looking at like the characteristics of something, leaving it in raw is probably fine. If you're looking for actual acceleration values and you need that for some reason, convert it to G's. The plots are going to look the same, but your units will be appropriate for your use case. So to make the most use out of this sensor, unless you already have something planned that you know works, I would recommend writing it to a text file on an SD card. The M0 Adalogger board is perfect for that, and gives you a lot of headroom if you're going to be using a lot more hardware or faster sensors, because it runs at 48 megahertz, which is really fast for a little microcontroller like this. If you want to go even faster, you can get the Teensy 4.1. I think that runs at 600 megahertz, which is crazy. But for light stuff, this is a really great board. It's got the SD card built in. The Teensy 4.1 also does. And so that's super helpful to just have that already built in. That's basically my quick start guide for getting the MMA8451 sensor up and running as quickly as possible with as few lines of code as possible. I know sometimes you just want to be able to get the bare minimum out of a sensor. You have a very specific use case for it. This is how to get it going as quick as possible. So I hope that was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other videos. If I missed something that you want to see covered, let me know. Maybe you'd like to see the SD card writing code as well. I can make a video about that. But I just wanted this to be really quick, short, and sweet. So anyway, thanks for watching. Be sure to be kind to someone today, and I'll see you next time. Peace.